because you just so smooth, she's feeling you. So she's like, oh, I want to get this guy some coochie. It could be
get this guy some, just some. Get, all right. Stop at some.
Maybe we can get this guy some, but that don't mean she. And you do got girls that let you hit on the first night. They nasty, but every girl that let you hit, every girl that played, yeah. I know it's played. Every girl that let you hit on the first night don't mean that she's a whore because she let you hit. Maybe you just that guy. So don't ever discredit yourself for a girl letting you hit because the first night. I know me personally, I ain't get it the first night, but usually I'm that nigga. I get it the first night or the second night. And I don't even try. And I don't even care because it's not about coochie. It's way deeper than coochie with me. When I was a little, when I was running the streets, then yeah, but now it's way deeper than that. So I let her talk. Now? Yeah.
Okay. So I feel like you shouldn't, if that's
okay.
I feel like if that's your, when you're going out with a girl and if that's your goal just to get someone on the first date, then that's kind of corny. Unless it is a hoe and you're just trying to hit, then it shouldn't even be no first date. You should just offer her some money and let her give you some ass. Now, if you're on a date with somebody that you like and potentially see yourself getting serious with, I feel like you shouldn't try to go there on the first date. But if it happens, you're grown. Like, people are grown. Grown people hook up all the time. Like, that don't make nobody no hoe. That doesn't make, you know, that don't make her a hoe. I feel like people just go off the energy. Like, you can meet somebody and y'all supposed to go to dinner.
Hey,
y'all,
diva.
Listen, you can meet somebody and go to dinner. And then y'all hit it off. Dinner go from being supposed to be an hour or something to long to y'all stay at the restaurant till the shit closed down. The manager telling y'all gotta get out because y'all vibing that deep. So you can't be mad at somebody for going home with you. Like, you know what I mean? It just depends on the vibe and how the person make you feel. You gotta just how to move.
I wanna say go for coochie.
Let me finish.
Somebody say keep saying coochie. I wanna go for the coochie for the first day if I like a girl. I go for the vibe. Fuck coochie. Anybody give you coochie?
Stop saying that. You right. Cut me off. Just sorry, so you can keep saying coochie.
Sorry.
So
you can get that from me.
So what I was saying is that doesn't make a woman a hoe. And if that is your goal to just try to get
you guys
some,
have a good night. Yes, it does.
No.
That's our friend, our contractor too. All
right,
yo,
bro.
You out for the night?
Yeah.
Put the garage down. What time you be here tomorrow?
Do the what now?
Keep put the garage down.
Yeah, what time you be here tomorrow?
45-7.
I'll be up. She won't. I'll be up.
Yeah.
Listen, I'll be up. She'll be up. Who answered the door?
You.
Every time.
You want to know why? You want to know why? Because I'll elbow his ass and send him down them steps. What? Text back? You want to know why? Oh, sign a check. That's what you think. He don't sign a check. I sign a check.
Well, they come out. They come out of my account. She signed.
I signed it. Oh, yeah. See, that's what you
know. See,
now, work. Now I'm gonna mess up that number. It's gonna be.
Listen, you see that little wrist move?
Uh-huh.
It's just a gesture of saying that's the man with the bank account.
You
see these orders popping.
Have a good night, bro.
Bye. All right. Thank you.
All right, that's good. All right, let's go. What else? Next question, man.
Wait,
question.
Hold on.
Next question.
No, I wasn't done. You cut me off. Coochie,
yeah, we
coochie,
can't
coochie.
Fit too much in one question.
Because you coochie. You shouldn't let me finish. So, it doesn't make a girl a hoe. It makes, when two grown people want to hook up, they just hook up. But if you're chasing it, that means you corny. And if she give it up,
you
don't.
Locked up, I was good from the front.
Oh, all right. Cool.
Oh, okay.
All right. Thank
brother.
You. All right, next question.
Pick.
No, I am trying. That's a you
Chance.
Question.
How you make your relationship last and keep it strong? Well, how you make your relationship last and keep it strong? It's not about the guy, not about the girl. It's about both of them. Y'all both gotta be willing to sacrifice certain things. You also gotta understand that
it's about the foundation.
You have to build a strong foundation. And building a strong foundation come within a female and come within the guy. Because you can have a guy that's really, really about it. If the girl not, it won't work. You can have a girl that's really, really about it. If the guy not into it, then it won't work. So it takes two. And y'all both gotta understand reality and real life reality and what you want. What you want out of life versus reality is not what's is not going to happen.
You
so
a really big thing.
What?
How you keep a relationship strong?
What?
Same way you keep any foundation. A relationship is a foundation.
I wasn't done.
I know, but you was. I see where you was going with it, and I'm gonna let you finish that. But God.
Oh.
I pray.
Number one.
We pray together. That's important. I pray for Tevin. I pray over Tevin. You know what I'm saying? That is.
All right, go.
Don't do that. Don't. Oh, God, he playing with you, God.
No, I'm not. I love you, God. I'm not
playing. God.
Please.
See, he's scared, God. I like keeping it in check. I'm telling God. So, no, but,
We're right.
No, for real. But, you know, the foundation is set from, you know, God. Any foundation should be. You pray over it. You nurture it. A relationship is like a flower. It won't grow without water, sunlight. You have to love it and nourish it. And then comes understanding and communication, but first it's the foundation.
And a lot of guys got standards, a lot of girls got standards. Oh, I want this, I want a girl that don't do this, don't do that, don't do this, or a girl say, I don't want a guy that don't do this, don't do that. But it's one thing in what you want, and there's one thing is reality. We gotta set reality for what it is. Reality, reality, like there's a lot of things that a female want, but they gotta understand. What's real, what's fake? Because a lot of shit that we want is fake as fuck. It's not real. It's only on movies.
Okay, so
understand the difference between reality and what you want. And when the girl and the guy understand wants versus reality, they'd be okay.
Piggybacking off of this question, we have two same questions. So it's like the same as this one.
Same people.
No, it's not. It's like how does it make it last long?
If you're not gonna
post it. I ain't posting it. I'm saying it's the same thing. How to make it last long. So...
Well, what's long to you, first of all, right?
I think long is just like a long term, like some years. And I think that's all about like understanding and communication.
It's the same thing.
Nobody's perfect. You got to understand that nobody's perfect. And, you know, it's not about the fuck up. It's about how you make up.
Hold on. Let me cut you off. Everybody, send this to every girl, every guy y'all know in a relationship. And tell them to get on here right now.
It's not about a lot. You know, there's a lot of no relationship is going is perfect. So there's always going to be trials and tribulations. And it's not about the mess up. It's about the makeup. And it's about that goes as far as simple things like petty arguments all the way to fidelity. Like, you just have to have a foundation, and you have to it's the will. You have to want it. You have to want it to work. You know why the divorce rate is so high? Because people walk away. They don't fight for love like they used to back in the day. So you have to fight for what you want. But both, you can't fight a fight alone. Both people have to be in the ring fighting for the relationship. Next question.
Come on, y'all. Send this live out to everybody. Get us up to 500 to 1,000 live viewers. Send the live out. Tell them, anybody that need advice, tune in, check in.
Dang. It says, how many women actually been faithful and still got cheated on? Probably about
80%.
Maybe 90.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
And, how can I answer this question?
That's crazy.
It is a crazy question. But the thing is this.
I'm going to send a lot of
what? You're going to send it? Yeah. The thing is this. I feel like 90% won't. I feel like 50% of men cheat, 50% of men don't cheat. But I don't feel like because you cheat, you should.
Go ahead.
No, because you just turned
it
on.
It out.
All right. Ready again. Yeah, I mean, sometimes niggas just dogs. You could be faithful as hell, do everything right, and some niggas just still go out and do what the hell they want. Some niggas just dogs. You can't control that. But what you don't do is let what the last man did, reflect on what the new man get, because you can be blocking new blessings. I know a lot of girls get cheated on by multiple men, but they put a shield up. But then guess what? The shield you putting up is not only blocking out the bad, it's blocking out the good. So you gotta understand that because you put the shield up don't mean you're gonna be great. Because the nigga of your dream can be coming, the God of your dream, I meant to say, can be coming to be with you, and you can block him out because you got to show up from what the last guy did. So, nah, you gotta accept people for who they are, or don't accept who they are. And just because you fuck up sometimes don't mean you can't forgive. Not saying you have to, because it's hard to forgive somebody for cheating. But grandmoms and granddads, do you think they're together so long because nobody cheated? When y'all see grandmoms and granddads together for 15, 20, 30, 40 years, y'all thought that shit was perfect? No. One of them fucked up before, but they're together for 40, 50 years because one of them or both of them fought for each other. Or one of them fought and the other one understood their love. So don't think because you're together 50 years, shit gonna be perfect. Like, 50 years is a long fucking time. 40 years, 30 years is a long time. Nobody going to be together that many years and don't do shit. It's impossible. I don't give a hell who said they will. It's impossible. The job is to stick together. The job is to be together and believe in each other and better each other and become a better human being, a better woman, a better man, a better husband, a better wife. That's it. Hey, Lowe's, I see you in here, Lowe's. What you were saying? Is it weird to jack off if I'm in a relationship? I mean, I'm not. That's like a freaky question to ask. Like, I won't even answer that question. Like, that's wrong, bro.
No, it's not weird.
But I'm gonna answer it. I'm gonna answer the question because I'm on live. She on live, and it's only fair. You heard the question. No, it's not fair.
No, I'm saying
it's not weird. It's not weird.
It's just up to you.
Sometimes, listen, as a man, right? Let's say you hitting that shit so good, she hurting, right? Hold on.
I'm not saying I'm just looking fly.
Let's say you hitting this girl so your girlfriend so much, she hurting her, and one day you horny and she not. What you gonna do? Are you going to what is it called? Starve yourself? What is it called?
What?
If I'm horny and you not?
I don't know what you're trying to say. Starve yourself. What are you talking about?
If I'm horny and you're not horny, should I sacrifice and just be stressed the fuck out? Or should I go beat my meat?
Here's no toilet seat and beat your meat.
Alright, so to answer your question, no. Beat your meat if she don't want to fuck or suck or whatever she want to do, beat your meat. Beating your meat is better than cheating. Because guys, when your girlfriend doesn't want to do certain shit, right? Hold on. When your girlfriend want to do certain shit, you think like, damn, she don't want to suck my dick. I know this bitch suck my dick. But guess what? When you beat your dick, you don't think my none of this shit no more. Guess what you do? All that shit get relieved. So beat your meat. Long as you going was upbeat. No, I'm gonna answer two beat me questions. Next question. Sorry. Ask another question. I'm gonna answer two of those. That the first one was freaky for me to answer, and I did it. I'm gonna answer two of them. No boxing questions right now. Yo, you crazy.
How do you feel about him?
Hold on, this one. Oh, right. I like that.
2 years. About 2 years.
Almost 2 years.
Instagram.
I just talk.
Instagram. We met on Instagram. I'm kind of tired of telling the story, but we met on Instagram. I followed Tevin, and I liked some of his pictures. Like, just liking it. I wasn't fishing, but I liked his pictures. And then he went on my page and liked my pictures back. We went and liked each other's pictures for like a whole day straight. He DM'd me. I DM'd back. We exchanged numbers, and we've been talking ever since.
So, ladies, answer the DM, and guys, send them DMs out to them girls. Period, cool. Nobody meet in person no more. You see what all these?
What is the key to live a happy with a wife?
You asking me or what was? With his wife. Always let your girl, always let your wife, your girl, for your fiance, always let her feel involved. Even if you don't want to, let her feel involved. Make her feel important. Girls want to feel involved and important. The same way guys want to feel like you, a girl need them. That's just period. So for all the females that say, oh, I don't need a nigga, I don't need a guy, I don't need... Only thing you're doing is fucking up your chances of getting a good guy. Because a good guy wants you to need him. Not saying that we want you to be on your back and starving, but I want my girl to need me. Because guess what? If my girl need me, it make me strive harder for her. If she don't need me, I'm not going to give a fuck. I mean, oh, she don't need me. She be all right. She be okay. So, to answer the question, just make it feel love. Because there's so many Instagram models and
I need you okay. to put oil in my hair tonight.
All right. That's a different need, nigga. But anyway, there's so many bad females out here on Instagram. Your girl may not have the big titties. Your girl may not have the big butt, the fat ass. Your girl may not have the cutest face. Or your girl may not have whatever, but make her feel like she's the cutest, have the biggest titties, the fattest ass, and make her feel like she's the best in the world. And that's how you got to do it. And then... When you treat your girl like that, guess how she gonna treat you? Fucking like everything. She gonna love the shit out you.
Oh shit. I clicked the wrong thing. Sorry, guys.
You can't do that. That same person. Go up.
Yeah.
What is it?
It's a woman cheating on her.
What?
Yes.
All right. Okay. Is a woman cheating more hurtful?
No, you can come over here. Get this back up.
Oh, right here.
You don't want to be all next to me?
No, right here.
A woman cheating is worse than a man cheating because a man cheats without thinking. He cheats without, you know, he's thinking with another head. When a woman cheat, it's emotional. A woman has premeditated that cheating. She has fantasized it about her head, and it's most likely a second relationship. Women just don't just cheat. A woman cheats when she is planning an exit in her head or when she is planning something. Like, when a woman cheat, she fed up. When a woman, like, you in a serious relationship with a good woman and she cheat, you didn't push her that far. Or not saying that you didn't push her that far, your relationship has deteriorated so much, separated so much that she has seek love elsewhere because women just don't go catch a quick fuck.
All right. When a girl cheat, like she said.